Hey there guys, what's going on? My name is Mark and welcome back to our FIFA 21 Hamburger Road to Glory career mode. We are into double figures now, episode 10, and it's the last one of the year. After this one, this should be going up around the 23rd, maybe, and I'm just gonna take, you know, a few weeks off, and I'll be back in the new year, ready to rumble, and then we're just gonna smash all the way through, hopefully a video every week, up until we finish this save. But that's enough about next year. We need to finish this year on a high, I think. And we've got three big games to finish the year on. Obviously, you can see we're going to start it with RB Leipzig, who right now are struggling in the Bundesliga. You can see from up there, and you'll be able to see from the table right now, they are smack bottom of the league. 0 wins, 0 points. They are really struggling at the start of this season. So maybe this is a good time to play them. Then after that, we welcome Wolfsburg to the Volkspark Stadion, and we finish it off with the biggest game there is. We're away at Bayern Munich. So not a bad three games to finish 2020 off on, I think. And if you did miss last episode, we went past deadline day. We made two signings. We made a backup left-back signing, Felix Agu. Not very sharp right now, so we just need to get him trained on and make sure he's fit and ready to step in to this left back position if we need him. And you can see him in the middle. Eduardo Camavinga also signed, a break the bank signing. Not a bad few signings we made this transfer window. As you can see, we've got Mesut Ozil, Lars Bender, Camavinga and Felix Agu. Not a bad transfer window. So let's just get straight into these games, I reckon. Starting it off away at Leipzig. Like I said, currently bottom of the Bundesliga, not being able to really get going this season. So let's hope that we can just nick something here, because a point away at Leipzig, one of the title challengers nowadays, it's normally Bayern Munich, Borussia Dortmund and RB Leipzig are the three up there challenging for the Bundesliga title. And let's see if we can get a point, because a point away from home against Leipzig would be a massive result and probably the biggest result so far. So let's get into it. Away at Leipzig. Let's do it. Here we go then. We have arrived at the Red Bull Arena in Leipzig to take on the Bulls, the RB Leipzig. It's a good game, I think, that's going to happen here. It's got all the makings of a quality game. Newly promoted side versus title challengers. One of these teams is bottom of the league, and it's not the newly promoted sides. It's got all the makings of a spicy little clash, this one. Alright, Leipzig starting with Peter Galaxy in goal, back four from Wasser, Savage, Zagadou and Mukalele. Midfield two of Lima and Adams. Attacking midfielders, yes, of Nkunku and Forsberg. And then a top two of Iñaki Williams and Angel? I've no idea. They've got some good players in there. It's quite surprising that they're struggling as badly as they are right now. We're starting, obviously, with Ulreich in goal, a back four of Leibold, Jung, Van Drongelen and Lars Bender. Midfield three of Camavinga, Marcus Antonio and Mesut Ozil. And then the front three is Kittel, Jatta and Suarez through the middle. Look at that, Mesut Ozil leading the team talk there, and Mikel Arteta wants to say that he's not worthy of a place in the Arsenal squad. So it's Iñaki Williams to get this game underway, and we are off. It has all the makings of a tasty clash. Let's make sure it is. Let's try and nick something here, boys. Come on. Lima to Adams to Angel, slips that through to Iñaki Williams. Van Drongelen tries to stand him up, and he does. Forces him back, does really well, does Rick Van Drongelen, but they've still got the ball. Angel, that's a lovely move, and within 10 minutes, RB Leipzig have taken the lead. And could this be normal service resumed for Leipzig? Because I don't think we've touched the ball. Lovely play. I don't know who played that through. It's Iñaki Williams who give the old back heel, and Angel just flicks it up and then volleys it past Ulreich. Eventually, it's going to show it into the bottom corner, like a bullet into the bottom corner, and Leipzig have an early lead. Mukalele up to Williams. Iñaki Williams now goes wide to Nkunku, to Mwasa, to Williams, back to Nkunku. Goes past Van Drongelen, his Lehmer now, in towards Iñaki Williams. Goes back to Nkunku. Iñaki Williams probably could have taken that shot off. It's fell to Lehmer, and I tell you what, Leipzig are starting to look like title challengers now. Corner taken short, up to Forsberg, back to Nkunku, the corner taker, back to Emil Forsberg now. back to Nkunku. These two just playing it between themselves. Gives it eventually to Angel, the goal scorer. We can't get close to him, and it's fell to Nkunku. And I'll tell you what, this could be a battering at this rate. Leipzig are carving us open. Hamburg cannot get out. And I'll tell you what, it's going to take a massive turnaround for us to get back into this. We just cannot get close to this ball. I think it's Angel now. Gets himself a goal and an assist. And it's Nkunku. Christopher Nkunku, it falls to in the box. And he just slams that first time back across. And Leipzig are looking unbelievable. We're going to change something. I know it's early, but fuck me, we need a change. I think you're on goal forward, right? You need to... Everybody needs to stay back right now. Because we are being twatted. Adams gives it away to Lars Bender now. Lars Bender to Ozil. Ozil plays it up the field to Suarez. Suarez needs to cut it onto his right. And there you go. Hamburg have got to go back. I don't know why he's booted the ball. Pick the ball up, Louis. Louis, pick the ball up. Pick it up. All right, then. We'll just skip it. Fuck the replay. We're going straight back. We need to just get this going. We need to keep this momentum going. Get an equaliser. Maybe nick something here. Lehmer. Out wide to Mouassa. Back to Lehmer. Lehmer to Inaki Williams to Angel. It's so easy for them. Inaki Williams is just unreal. He's too quick. He's I don't know how to explain it. He's not running at us, but his footwork, it's just too quick for us. The fact that he just spotted that ball first time, didn't take a touch, just tapped that off to Angel. Watch this here. It's there. No, we weren't expecting that pass. None of us were. Camavinga's just stood on the edge of the box, not really doing anything, so he's just stood there. And Angel's through, and he's got his second. What can we do from this? Oof. We're going to bring Camavinga off, because he's not really having the best of games. He's in Kunku. Leipzig coming forward again here. Mouassa. Is that a Q or an O in the middle of his name? I couldn't really see that. Inaki Williams. Van Drongelen puts a foot in on him. There you go, just hack him down, really. Now here's Tarodda. Tarodda lays it off to Ozil. Ozil now just going to have to slow that down. Keep hold of the ball. Good pass up to Dudziak. Dudziak to Tarodda. Tarodda to Mesut Ozil. Keep going, Mesut, lad. Mesut, finish that. Oh, flip. Ozil slips it through to Dudziak. First time, and it's in. I did not expect that to be going in. Why do you keep fucking kicking the ball? Pick it up. Pick it up. Oh, these fucking people, man. Pick the ball. I don't know what's wrong with these guys. Ozil there just slipped it through to Dudziak. And I'm not going to lie, I thought he scuffed that shot. But it turns out Dudziak, one of our subs that we made at halftime, him and Tarodda came on, has just got to go back. And once again, we have reduced the deficit to one. Now, let's just try and not, you know, concede again. Savage has put that over the top towards Sarachi. That's a name I haven't heard in a long time. Jesus Christ. I had him in the Peterborough save in FIFA 19. Fuck me. Marcelo Sarachi, what a man. 10 minutes to go. Can Hamburg find the equaliser? Or will Leipzig pull away again? Or will it just end like this? Ozil just cannot control the ball right now. But Leipzig keep on giving the ball away. They just keep booting it forward. There's no plan B, it looks like, for Leipzig right now. They're just booting it forward and we're winning it back. Here's Dani Olmo. Now they don't boot it forward, now that I've mentioned it. Here's Mukelele. Leopold tries to stand him up, and he does. Now here's Sonny Kittel. Goes past his man. That's a lovely play from Sonny Kittel. Kittel now. I'm waiting. Look at all this space. Look at all this space. Sonny Kittel, he's through. Sonny Kittel, he's put it away with 5 minutes to go. Hamburg have the equaliser. Oh, my word. Where has that came from? RB Leipzig have crumbled. They fumbled the bag. And Hamburg have a winner. Look at all this space in the middle for Sonny Kittel to run into. And he's done exactly that and buried it. And RB Leipzig have went from 3-1 up to drawn 3-3. It's a lovely comeback from Hamburg. Can they hold on and get a point? You never know with this momentum. Can Hamburg find a winner? Let's find out. There's about 5 minutes to go. Lehmer gets tackled by Marcus Antonio. Tarodda loses the ball though. And now Lehmer comes forward, gives it to Nkunku. Nkunku up to Williams. Ulreich with a massive save to possibly... Oh, he might have just kept us in that. Well, he has kept us in it, but he might have just rescued a point for us. But we do have to defend this corner. Let's just get rid of this, boys. Get rid of this. Marky men, get rid of it. Mukulele, Marcus Antonio off the line. Tyler Adams, it falls to. RB Leipzig have to get it in the middle. We need to get this ball and we need to get it away. Van Drongelen gets a tackle and Kittel boots it forward. And Jesus Christ, what a finish. Fuck me. Oh my word. Marcus Antonio clears it off the line and saves us a point. Oh, Hamburg have a point away at RB Leipzig. And after being 3-1 down, coming back to 3-all. Oh my word, what a game that was. I said at the start it had all the makings of being a spicy little clash, and I don't think I was wrong. What a game that was. RB Leipzig 3, Hamburger 3. Oh my god, I need to lie down. And that's only the first game of the episode. All right, then we are back at the Volkspark Stadion to take on Wolfsburg. And after an unreal final few minutes against Leipzig, we're just looking for a calmer game. Nothing too crazy. Just a win, really, boys. I know Wolfsburg are a good side here. Currently sitting second in the table after four or five games. I can't quite remember. But it would be nice to get a win here. And especially at home, you know, using the home fans as the 12th man. All right, but we are going with Sven Ulreich in goal. It's the same team as the last game. Leopold, Junk, Van Drongelen and Bender. Midfield three is Kamavinga, Ozil and Marcus Antonio. And the top three of Kittel, Jatta and Suarez. And Wolfsburg start with Castillo's in goal. A back four of Otavio, Nastasic, Pongracic and Mbabu. Arnold and Hendricks as a defensive midfield duo. Villa, Harit and Umer as an attacking three. And then Beretta, who without a face, is up top by himself. A little 4-2-3-1 formation. Alright, so we get this game underway and we are off. Let's do this, boys. Let's send the fans home happy. We've played one at the Volkspark Stadion this season and we've won one. Let's make this place a fortress. Corner in. Marcus Antonio heads it away. Not very well though. Arnold gets that back and it took a little deflection off of Jatta and that might have took all the momentum out of it. Marcus Antonio. Oh, it's a lovely first touch by Marcus Antonio. He's gone. Marcus Antonio now. There's a few options in the middle. Can he pick one out? It's towards the back post for Sonny Kittel. But Mbabu heads that around for a corner. That was lovely play by Marcus Antonio. I'm going to take this corner short. Marcus Antonio now pulls it back towards Jung. It's not really the best touch or the best person. I kind of wanted it to go to anybody else. Ozil now. Good ball, Suarez. Oh, Castillo's there with a save. That was a fantastic ball by Mesut Ozil. Ulreich, big throw through the middle of the pitch to Ozil. Ozil, oh, that's a good ball. Marcus Antonio's going to get on the end of that. Good first touch, squares it. Oh, it's lovely play. And Luis Suarez gives us the lead just after the half-hour mark. And it was good play, that, wasn't it? Good first ball by Ozil. Marcus Antonio with a good first touch and unselfishly taps that across. And we are going to get a 360 angle of this. Why? It's literally tapping into an empty net. Tony Villa now goes back to Otavio. Back to Villa, to Amin Harit. Van Drongelen doing really well there. I remember when he couldn't get games. is Suarez onside there? Was he? Oh, it's Ozil. Doesn't really matter. Doesn't matter who it was. Ozil, that's a great ball. Kamavinga! And he's there! And he's got his first goal for the club. Eduardo Kamavinga has done it. 2-0. I don't know what minute we're on. I'd say just about half-time. And it's Ozil with another good pass. He didn't get the assist for the first one, but he is going to get it for this one. Good ball in. And again, it's another 360 replay. I mean, I guess this one was on a volley, but still, it's quite an easy finish. But Kamavinga arrives just at the right time and absolutely slams it right into the middle of the Hamburg logo in the net. It was a bullseye. Eduardo Kamavinga is off the mark. If we could make this place a fortress, then we'll be great, I think. And, we are fourth or fifth right about now. And this win might, if we can hang on, there's still the entire second half to go. And now that I've said that, they might just come and jinx me. But if we can hold on to this, it might push us further up the table. But I do think eventually when other teams start firing, you know, the Leipzig, when they start going, because if they play like they did against me, then they'll be, you know, they'll be up there And that's a great ball by Camavinga. Sonny Kittle's in here. Can he bag the third of the game? Yes, he can. Hamburg are critical. They cannot stop scoring right now. 3-0. And yeah, I'm unsure about that celebration, to be honest. Good ball by Camavinga. Finally, we're not going to get a 360 replay. Just takes it forward, gives the keeper the eyes. Simple, slotted goal into the bottom corner. I can't finish making my point because every time I do, I keep getting interrupted. I do think, come the end of the season, we'll be bottom half. Mid-table is what I'm aiming for. I don't think we're going to do anything special. But, you know, from 8th to 12th is what I'm aiming for. And I do think we'll be there or thereabouts. I think right now we're performing too good to be in a relegation fight. Oh my fucking God. Oh my God! Sonny Kittle has backed a worldie! What a goal that is by Sonny Kittle. He cannot stop scoring recently. Oh my Christ. Just getting onto his right. I mean, he could have taken it further forward. Look at him. He's got all the space in the world. But he just decided, nah, I'm going to go for this. Keeper's off his line a little bit. And oh my word. What a goal from Sonny Kittle. Oh, that could be dangerous. I fucking knew straight away. There's normally a... Leopold's normally there. Come on, fight him. How has he won that? How did he win that? How was that? How has he came out on top with that ball? I've literally tackled him and the game's just decided to give him it back. And there is the full time whistle. A 4-1 win for Hamburger. And again, I don't want to say anything, but I think the Volkspark Stadion is a little bit of a cheat code. Our home form is looking quite good. Sure, we've only played 2 games at home so far, but we've won both of them. So it's a 100% record. Sonny Kittle has 100% shooting accuracy in this game. 2 shots, 2 goals, one of them being an absolute screamer. 4 goals, 3 points, but next up is the toughest challenge possibly in the world right now. Oh, I've just completely forgot to talk. It's match day, Bayern Munich versus Hamburger, and we're away at Bayern. It's a big game. I don't know what, why is it called Sanderson Park? That's not the name of Bayern Munich's arena, is it? This is a big game. This is massive. I fully expect us to get clapped here. Fully expect us to get walked over. But we're gonna give it a good old shot, aren't we? We've even changed tactically for this one. We're aiming for a point. I'm not gonna lie. I've parked the bus already. Bus is already parked. Alright, so Bayern Munich go with Manuel Neuer in goal. A back four of Luke Shaw, Umtiti, Mark Bartra and Saar. Wijnaldum and Leva in the middle. Attacking midfield of Costa, Goretzka and Gnabry. And then up top, there's the main man, Robert Lewandowski. That is a weird side. Kimmich on the bench, Sane on the bench. What the... Luke Shaw? We are going with Sven Ulreich in goal. A back five. Yes, 5 of Leopold, Jung, Leicester, Van Drongelen and Lars Bender. Midfield 4 of Kittle, Ozil, Marcus Antonio and Jada. And then up top by himself, the big man, Simon Terodde. Decided to go with Terodde because I have a feeling that we're not going to get any of the ball. And when we do, I'm going to boot it long to try and find him. So Lewandowski gets this game underway and we are off at the Allianz Arena. And I don't know what to say. Luke Shaw. Wijnaldum puts that in the middle towards Goretzka. And Ulreich holds that. And we're just going to hold it for a little bit. Like I said, I don't want this to be a very entertaining game, to be honest with you boys. And I don't think you do either. I want this to be a boring 0-0. With hardly any chances. Because I've parked the bus. I've gone 5 at the back. I've gone 4. When was the last... I don't think I've ever gone with a 4-man midfield. Oh, Lewandowski in a bit of space. Can't give him that. Slips it through with Leon Goretzka, who's gone for that. And that is wide. We'll take that all day long. All day long, we'll take that. All right, into the second half. And the game plan's worked. They've been reduced to a couple of shots, a couple of pot shots. Nothing too dangerous in the first half. And, you know, if we just carry on defending as we're doing, we might be able to nick something here. And that's a good ball if Jada can stay on, but he didn't. That was a great ball. Lewandowski to Goretzka. Goretzka to Lewandowski. He hasn't really had anything of note in the game so far, Lewandowski, but we can't take that for granted because all he needs is one chance. Now here's Serge Gnabry. He does well to cut inside. Leopold Ulreich saves the first one and manages to gather the seconds. Goretzka now. It's to Wijnaldum. Oh, he's got past Rick van Drongelen. Rick van, there you go, lad. Back at him. Don't win the first, get the seconds. That's lovely stuff. Goes out wide to Luke Shaw. Back to Wijnaldum. Here's Lewandowski in the middle towards Goretzka. Got to get in there. Oh, it's took a deflection. Ulreich saves. Prevent the corner, prevent the corner, prevent the corner. Thank you. Corner in by Douglas Costa. We've got to win that. Lewandowski. Oh, he's missed. Oh, Lewandowski puts it wide from about 6 yards out. Oh, I tell you what, it's just wide as well. He'll be kicking himself with that one, will Lewandowski? Joshua Kimmich. We're just going to try and get Leisner back into his position. Because I don't really like him being out wide, but he's the only man here, so I've got to get in there. Gnabry's headed that on towards Goretzka. Oh, my God, they've just carved me open. Oh, and it's a heartbreaking stuff. Bayern Munich take the lead in the 70th minute. And it's Gini Wijnaldum with the goal. Oh, it's heartbreaking stuff because we've defended so well. But they've just carved us open with a bit of skill. And like I said, I wanted Leisner to get back. And that's why he just got dragged out of position. And I had to defend with him. Otherwise, it would have been open. And it's, I don't know who put that across. I think it was Goretzka who, instead of shooting, just dragged it across. And Wijnaldum's there to tap into the empty net. And Bayern Munich take the lead. A deserved lead. Let's not beat around the bush. They do deserve the lead. But, God, we defended so well. Next time the ball goes out, we might as well just go back to our 4-3-3 and just push forward. Because if we're losing, we might as well lose trying to score. Which, you know, we haven't really done. Have we had a shot this game? Have we had a shot? We're not going to be able to make those changes because the whistle's about to blow. And it is going to be a loss for Hamburger. Gnabry to Lewandowski. Can we keep it to a 1-0 loss? It looks like we can. Yes, we can. We do lose, but only by one, and we played really well. You know, not attacking-wise. Attacking-wise, we didn't do anything. But defensively, we frustrated them. And that's two times now where, you know, the top two of the Bundesliga have only been able to beat us by one goal. So we're doing quite well. We're not quite getting the points against them, you know, but nobody expects us to get the points against Bayern Munich or Borussia Dortmund. But we are doing well. We're performing well against them. And again, just like Borussia Dortmund, there is positives to take from that. Alright, so that is where I'm going to finish it for today. And I think next time in the new year, what we're going to do is we're just going to do October. We'll probably play Borussia Mönchengladbach, Schalke, and we'll probably do Mainz in the DFB Pokal. Maybe we might be able to go on a little bit of a cup run. But after those results this time, we currently find ourselves in fifth. We went into the Bayern Munich game above them. I know, absolutely shocking. But that win put them above us just by a point. We are in the top five. We won't finish there, let's be honest. Like I said, I'm aiming for about 8th to 12th, and you know, hopefully then, you know, then maybe next season we can build, maybe push for a top 8, and then after that, we'll see. If you did enjoy it, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll be back in the new year for the next episode of this save. I'm aiming for, let me just get up the calendar, I'm aiming for around the 7th of January for when I want to be back. So like the second week in January, that's what I'm aiming for. That's why I'm going to finish it. Thanks for watching this year. If you did enjoy, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe. That's all I've got for you. Have a lovely Christmas. If you don't celebrate it, have a nice Friday. Happy New Year. Still be sure to stay safe. Still wash your hands and have a nice day. All I'm after, I can't believe I even